Our robot's intake mechanism uses a pair of 4-inch diameter rubber wheels from Andy Mark that are powered by Tetrix motors. The intake wheels are angled at 45 degrees to guide the block up an intake ramp into the holding area for secure transfer to the claw mechanism. Before settling on a wheel intake, we experimented with other concepts, such as using cardboard prototypes and by hand-holding partially built mechanisms. We had an early success with a claw that would be used for both intake and stacking, but we realized that even though it was easier to have a single mechanism, the intake claw was slow and clumsy. We decided that an intake claw wouldn't be good enough to let us reliably collect and place 2 stones during autonomous mode, which was our main goal. Our first concept of intake wheels used springy arms that could open up to accept blocks in different orientations, but they took up a lot of room, and we kept snapping the rubber bands that squeezed them together. Next, we tried hard-mounted intake wheels, but they were so rigid that it kept bending the robot's chassis. So we changed the wheel's motor mounts from aluminum to polycarbonate, which gave us a good balance of flexibility and durability. The wheel intake angle is important to control so the stones will go up the ramp into the holding area without crashing into the ramp or spinning over the top of the intake mechanism. We adjust the intake wheel spacing to be tight enough to grip the stones during intake, but loose enough that they can handle blocks at different approach angles. We realized that our intake is more reliable if we can clean the wheels with a wet towel between matches to remove the dust and debris. Finally, some of our earlier intake mechanisms caused the robot to be unbalanced. With a Mecanum drive chassis, we need the weight to be centered in the robot to have consistent movement. We kept modifying our intake mechanism to make it lighter and move its weight closer to the middle of the robot.